This week, a trial started in Harry Smith. And it's a trial about a service delivery protest that went bad, that turned violent. Now, obviously, the details of this protest will be canvassed in the course of the trial. But the version of events that's being related by the conveners is that the violence was a response to state violence, that a perfectly legitimate legal protest was suppressed prematurely by the police, and that there was also police brutality that took place against a number of protesters, which led to this organic spread of outrage in the community that resulted in a situation where ANC offices were burnt down and two ANC councillors were attacked, and apparently one councillor was beaten so badly that his leg was broken. Now, you know, this for me is a very profound story. It's a story that for me encapsulates a lot of the very tragic tales of what's going on in more marginalized parts of our country. It's a story that remains unreported. The trial isn't being focused on. Even at the time of the protest, the only report that I could pick up on was by SABC News. People out there are saying, why are we not being heard? Why have we been abandoned? The last time the media were here reporting on the service delivery issues in Harry Smith was when a 17-year-old youngster was shot and killed in a service delivery protest that really sparked the uprisings in the Free State. And people are saying really bitter things, and they're saying things like, does it take another 17-year-old youth to be shot in a service delivery protest for the media to come back and to look at what's happening in our particular area? And people are also saying other things as well, like media freedom is under pressure at the moment. And we're being asked by media organizations to defend the media's freedom, which is perfectly correct, because media freedom is in the SANEF, as SANEF argues, is everybody's freedom. But what has the media done to defend our freedom and the erosion of our freedom? And I think a related question to that is, aren't you doing democracy a disservice by, in reporting on protest action, focusing on primarily on the moment of protest rather than on the drivers of protest, the things that gave rise to it, and the things that have happened in its wake? Because this doesn't help us to build up an understanding of what is actually going on in these particular areas. Because what it seems to be contributing to is a perception out there that the only way to get one's voices heard is to burn down ANC offices and break the councillor's leg.